several nerfs to him when you nerf different things like Mask of Madness
Lion.
That is going to indirectly target him. There was a meta where Juggernaut was picked all the time, but
Yeah. Hopefully
we're not there anymore.
Still in the mid lane, as you said. The lead here for the S7 moves.
Oh, top lane, they're going to go in on March.
March. Rabbit going forward here with the... And now with the stun. March is out in place. He's got the charge. He's going to be able to get it off there. This, I don't think the poison damage is going to be quite enough. He should be okay. He's going to be very low. Bottom lane, though. KP went in onto June. Oh! The final right click there from KP reaching around the tower. And that's going to be your first blood there to KP. And as I said, this is the carry, the player.
Gonna walk in and ward? No, he didn't ward actually. He's just gonna take a Maledict. And
yeah.
I'm not sure about this movement from June here.
June popping the cogs. One raise comes through onto June. QI looking for a second one. Will find it. Corner breaks. Is it going to save you against those magical raises? But the side of Newbie, they want to try and find somebody in return. Move on to Febby. Will find the kill. Now move with Sanchez. Can he turn it around? It's QI. No, Sanchez's got to run. But QI, that's going to find a kill. It's a double kill already for the SF. And now they're going to try and chase for more. Going up to the high ground. KP moving in. He's got level 4 Blade Fury. And he's not going to be able to quite close the gap between the two of them. But double kill for the side of MVP, bringing it to 3-for-2 on the scoreboard. Moving towards the rune spot here. QO and Nuts are about. He's going to just drop the cocks here. They're trying to go in with the Maledict as well. Jew's got to be careful. Corner Brace is going to help him for the time being, but QO, he wants the kill. Moving in with one raise. Should be able to find the punches after. Stick charges from Jew. And now the hookshot. Trying to turn it, but it doesn't matter. Jew's down. QO's going to lose his life into Mu, though, as they find the kill in return. And it's simply a 1-for-1.
The Queen of Pain, he does not have... Oh, he does have a Mango, though.
It's TPM from Jug, who has to...
This is a problem for Rabbit.
Get the charge onto Rabbit. Rabbit's going to blink straight away, but they're going to go for this one, potentially. March continuing on the charge. He's going to need a bash or two. Oh, he's going to turn on this. The TP's come out. He's a little bit spooked. He's going to go for the TP. They haven't got anything to catch up, but the damage with the Sonic Wave. They'll bring him down, and that's what you get for TPing out.
Help from the side.
We'll see if he can turn this one around, because with Nuts and Febby in the neighborhood, March is going to want to go all the way in for this one. Here we go, but the Hex is there, as you said. He's going to try and turn it around with the Earth Spike. Now June coming in with the cogs, holding March in place, the finger as well. March,
what a cast,
though! It's doing a lot, it's not quite enough. Now it's Nuts is in trouble as well, but now to June and Sanshay, looking for another kill for the side of Newbie. They're going to chase down Nuts. He's walking around with a healing one. It's not going to save you. Heal that up, Mother Drucker. Rabbit with the kill. Two kills for Newbie. And maybe even more. QM Febby coming in. Febby with the track. Maybe MVP can try and salvage this. Find something in return. Oh! The shuriken bounces. They'll find the Wyvern. Now they turn to Rabbit. He's going to blink in 1 second. It's not enough. KP with the Omni Slash. Finds something in return. And it ends up being a 2-for-2 trade between the sides.
Ooh, a lot of points charge,
but there's a lot here again. March says, I'm out of here.
Oh, that could be cursed.
The Witcher's Curse cancelling the TP. Four heroes going straight in onto KP with a Hex as well. There's no way that fish can flop away. He's going to go down, and they're looking for March as well. There is a hookshot available. Is he going to try for it? Now March is out. March is out with the charge. But getting the Juggernaut, that's big there for Newbie.
Pretty sure. Yeah, it's minus 15 armor and Roche with Melstrike as well as that, so very powerful. As Banana is going to find Febby here. This is going to be a very easy kill. Wait, he smokes by mistake.
He smokes. That's not a dust, son. He does get the dust out in the end, and they'll find the kill. But a bounty hunter down and a smoke down. March looking for the TP out. Nothing to cancel that one. March will escape. Febby not as fortunate there. Just waiting to see if anyone else comes towards it. Bottom lane, that's going to start to get the push on again. MVP, they've got to be careful. Sanchez moving in here. Trying to look for a QO. We'll find the slow here with the Arctic Burn. KP's actually blade through straight into four of them. He says, we're going for this. And then he says, no, actually, we're out. Nuts backing up as well. Hookshot now to QO. Going to break it up in the river. KP can't get past. Sonic Wave onto two. Now they're looking for KP here with the Hex. Death Ward's being dropped. Nuts with the high ground. But the Witcher's Curse catches Nuts from the high ground. Catches the Death Ward. But he gets the Omni Slash out. KP, can he find a kill? One more. Two, but again, Newbie coming out on top as they take down both the SF and the Juggernaut.
That's awkward.
Oh, he's going to be able to blink away, but KP, QO, Nuts moving, and can they catch out the Queen of Pain? She's going to have another blink here in a second. She's got a Yules complete as well. Rabbit should be able to get herself out, but a very close encounter there with the Spirit Breaker. Newbie now, they're looking for a smoke. Moving into the jungle, they've got a hookshot available. QO and Febby farming up a camp. It might be their last camp for a bit of time, because June coming in, the Surf Spike onto Febby, looking for QO, but QO with the race is bringing Sanchez low. The finger onto QO. Febby, he's going to fall almost out of the yes. They do find the kill. June stuck in the cogs. He pops it down the Death Ward. Hitting onto June. Oh, it'll bring down the top one. KP looking for Mu now. Moving in. Can he find this? The Winter's Curse onto QO, holding March and Nuts back. KP getting low. Mu, look at the damage he's doing here with the Desolator. One more hit. Not quite enough to bring that KP. Now March with the bashes. What a fine move. What a fight there for MVP, taking three heroes down on the side of Newbie, and it was Newbie who were looking to fight that off the back of their own smoke.
when to throw it and just reading the fight very well.
Oh, shot onto Femi. They've got the Cox as well, but they don't have any detection, at least on the June. Now, Banana coming in with the sentry. Now the Hex onto Femi. Nowhere for the bounty to run, and Newbie will find themselves a lone bounty. Look for the tier one in the mid lane. Should be able to find it as well. A charge will be coming through. I think Moo's going to be well and truly over to the other side of the map. At least he's going to try too much. He's going to follow through with this one. Now Rabbit blinking forward. They want to catch out the Space Cow. Going for it. Nuts and Febby are there with a backup. But is it going to be enough? The cars bouncing between Banana and Moo. But Rabbit with the Sonic Wave will blow up the Primarch Spirit Breaker. He's going to buy back QO with the Requiem for the River. But now with the Winters goes on to KP. Holding the jug in place. Moo will be able to find that. It's too much damage here for the TA. But now with the hookshot onto QO holding him into place. Now he's turning around with the raises. June getting low. But Moo, he's doing too much damage with his Desolator. Now March with the charge. He needs to do something here because March brought back. If he finds his kill, and he will. Can he find Rabbit as well? Rabbit blinking himself away. It looks like the Queen will get herself out of this one.
She might try for the snipe on Febby here. She could have got the kill here, but might have risked her own life. And
he's going to do it fairly quickly with the damage and the crits from KP, but I'm sure Newbie will want to contest.
This is very good placement for the healing ward. The least likely cliff to be checked by Sandstrain, the Wymer.
Moving in with the Arctic Burner. He's got the Winter's Curse available. He's gonna use it straight away. Now with the jump in here from Moo. The damage, the side blades. Look at the side blades go. Now on June with a hookshot. Trying to disrupt on the fight, keeping Nuts and Febby out of it. Sandstrain and Moo, though, they're getting on. QO's done too much here with the Requiem and the Wymer right click. Sandstrain, you can't fly away from that. Oh, Banana with the biggest figure of his life. Taking a kill and return. It's a 2-for-2 so far. Sonic Wave from Rabbit clicks QO and Febby. Febby getting a south. QO going north. June's gonna try and chase this one down. QO's gonna look to deflect the end. No, he's going for the team.
Oh,
he gets himself out. He gets himself out, which means MVP take that trade there. 3-for-2.
I cannot believe he got out of that mess.
Oh, man.
He's more likely to engage on Shadow Fiend if he can catch him before he gets PKP up, and maybe they're looking for mid KP.
There's Banana revealing the blink straight in, and he'll be able to secure the kill there onto the Juggernaut. Big pickoff there for the side of Newbie with that.
A small timing window where they can go for that fight with the Death Ward if they can find an engage with the Spirit Breaker. Or if they just get jumped on instead.
He's come out a little bit too hard. Pops the BKB, the Red Crew. Catching June, bringing him down to half. But now Sandstrain with the Winter's Curse onto Nurse. March starts hitting his own team. KP coming in with the Blade Fury. They'll finish off the Witch Doctor there. And now Arch trying to fight this through with another strike. But Moo taking a fair bit of damage. Sonic Wave from Rabbit. But the Omni Snatch coming through. Rabbit, he's got the Yules to dodge it off. June moving in to try and help out the Quad. But the Quad.
Oh!
Is able to blink himself away. Now June's in trouble. They're turning it around. They're looking for Moo here as well. They might find four. Aegis is going to hit the deck.
They've got Blade Fury. He's dead.
He is
not going to blink out of this one.
This guy's getting out of this one. Moo, stuck between a rock and a hard place. He'll go down as well. Four kills for the side of MVP, and they only lose the Witch Doctor. To witness yourself, it's a little bit sad. He didn't get to use the Death Ward, but I think he'll be fine with what the team were able to do on top of that. Look at the gold increase and the XP increase. And this game is not been working out all the time for him, and the MVP. Ready to put some pressure on this middle lane. Onto the tier two. Sashin just throwing out the Splinter Blast, coming in with the Arctic Burn Harass, but there's a charge on him, and QO moving up to the high ground. Can they find this? But the Hex onto QO from Banana. Maybe they could turn this one around. SF's already a half elf. Moo coming in with the right click. BKB's pop on both the TA and the SF. The Winter's Curse cancelling the Requiem there. QO caught out for this one. Oh, the slash onto Sandshen, though. They'll find the Wyvern. KP moving in onto Rabbit. Mars charging forward onto June with Blade Fury as well. June in a lot of trouble. Will get taken out with the raises there from QO. And it will be a 3-for-1 buyback, in fact, from Lion here.
Yeah, this is very confident, but they know a lot of big abilities are on cooldown. There's no Winter's Curse. There's no Queen of Pain ult for a little bit.
Oh,
might have overextended after all, though.
Damage to the finger as well. QO getting low. Oh, March with the charge just in time to stop Rabbit getting the final touch in. Moo will blink forward, get the physical damage in. They'll bring down the SF. Now holding himself in place here with the Yules, trying to get himself out. Rabbit's going to be okay. It's now MVP on the retreat. Banana moving forward.
Oh,
onto March. Thanks to the vision granted by the Rocket Flare. Now Moo with the right clicks, trying to juke this one out. March. Febby's going to look for the TP out. Will escape. March as well tries for it. He won't be as lucky. They'll find the Spirit Breaker. And Newbie there with the successful defense.
And it seems like it's been QO's approach in the games of Shadow Fiend we've seen to go for this build. Like, very, very tanky build. Not the highest of damage.
He wants to go straight in. Charge here onto Banana. Fight's going to kick off. Looking for the Nether Strike. Winter's Curse now thrown down onto March. Moo coming in with a finger as well. March is just a little bit too tanky. June hookshotting across. Sonic Wave blasts down March on the Spirit Break with the Omni Slash coming through. Nuts, he'll be able to find the kill onto the Clockwork. And KP moving forward with the Blade Fury. They'll find Moo. It's a killing spree now for the Juggernaut. They look for Sanchez as well. The Skadi from QO is just doing too much damage. Double kill here for the Shadow Fiend. Definitely in the better position at this point. So they're going to move forward, maybe try and go for the high ground here. Moves being tracked up, a banana here with a stun onto Kyo. The damage coming from him, but it's just not enough. Kyo's just too damn tanky. With a healing ward dropped as well by KP. Winter's Curse now coming out. KP's going to fall. They'll find the kill of the Juggernaut, but Kyo with a Red Grip coming out. Move. He's been called Embrace. He's going to be okay for the time being, but they're just going to continue to fight. June's had to back himself off on the sidelines. Banana getting very, very low here. Throws out the finger. Kyo might just fall here. No, Mu, he hasn't got the damage. No, the paralyzing cards. The bounces. Mu out in place. He's going to go down. Will buy back straight away. It's a double kill for Kyo, though. He's incredibly low, but he's still got that Aegis here. Will go down once, but he's going to be back for round two. Mu trying to force march back out the base. What can the SF2 to fight up against? He's going to get Hexed up straight away. But again, the cards passing through onto Mu with the charge onto Banana. MVP.
Oh, no, that's it. Oh, no.
On the TA. Down for 100 seconds. Omni Slash. Banana's going to melt. Three heroes down to the side of Newbie. No buybacks available for them here. And MVP, they're going to go for the first set of racks. It's a nice sonic wave, but that's pretty much it. There's no follow-up, and Rabbit just has to blink himself the hell out of there. 34 for 24, MVP breaking the base, and Newbie falling apart. Still 80 seconds without the TA.
The Juggernaut with Wyvern's Winter's Curse onto the Shadow Fiend, but they don't have it yet.
Rabbit,
he does not have Wyvern either!
Brace might just save it for the time, and no! He goes down, and now the Death Ward drops down. Judas is GG! Newbie are out, the defending champions defeated in the first stage of the elimination matches, and MVP Phoenix will climb themselves forward.
Wow.
As LD would say.
Wow.
Wow!
That has got to be
the Wisp.
So either way, it's a really smart pick in four.
They went for wow. That's interesting.
It's gonna be off mid pop with Earthshaker. Like, it's very interesting.
If that doesn't work very early on, they're gonna get super out carried by Luna and Shadow Fiend if the Anti-Mage doesn't go battle free. Right?
Level one smoke. They've got the Tusk. He's incredibly strong. Here's just Snowball. Onto how? And the fish are coming out. Onto three. How's gonna be fine for the time being? And Funny. An echo turn their attention towards Super. Funny here looking for the body block. He's going to be able to find it here. Can they chase this one down? It doesn't look like they can. And even though Na'Vi get a nice wrap around there with the smoke gang, nothing to come of it. And maybe BG can try and turn this one around. Sudeiko's hanging about. We'll be able to tether himself back over.
Telekinesis an 8.
Funny should
have
be
a fissure.
He's got a snowball. I mean,
he's screwed.
Oh, he's stuck. He's stuck. He's got a snowball, but it's not going to save him. It's going to go back in, but I don't think he gets himself out of this one. Funny, oh, the heal effect from Arctol. But no, Telekinesis, he gets slammed down. And it's going to be VG finding the first blood there against the Tusk. And as soon as that happens, when they group up, they're going to have Howl with that aura, with that extra damage, and with that extra pushing power.
Oh, wait, they've managed to actually block up Sudeiko entirely in mid. At the same time, Dendi might get the kill on Sudeiko.
He gets it, Dendi, with the kill onto Super. Sudeiko only just getting himself out.
Yeah.
Na'Vi turning that one around very nicely.
They are very, very nervous in the mid lane. If Dendi lands a stun, Shadow Fiend might actually
this
die.
Is this big. Dendi needs to be careful.
Wait, what?
Oh, Ice, he's coming with the Rotom, but Dendi with the Laguna Blade and now Light Strike around to Ice. He might find a second fight with the Snowball. Ice, he's got no mana. Pulls the charges, it's not enough. Double kill for Dendi. But Super, he turns it around, finds a double kill for himself. It's going to be a double kill to both sides there in the mid lane as Vici very nicely recover against what Na'Vi were able to set out to do so there.
60 move speed or something like that, maybe even more.
And here's what you were talking about, the Dendi Funnick combo. Dendi leading in here with the Yule Scepter. Can he find the combo with the stun? Yes, he can. He's got a Laguna Blade as well. Bring Howl low. Howl, yeah, tries for the ult, but it's not going to come out. Does get taken down there. Sudeiko being credited with the kill. Super moving in with Fenrir. See if they can find something. He'll find the raises. Will be able to find himself one kill. See if he can find more. Dendi looks for the light trace. Going to be Duke Tower. Relocate back out is going to bring them back safely towards the mid lane.
You could say, since they don't lose their own tower, but. Well, they might very soon. Artstyle is not in the right position right now.
Totally caught out there by the side of Vici with that smoke.
He has 13-1 charges as well. For Na'Vi to blow up Super, they need to land their entire combo perfectly, and there needs to be no counterplay. And of course, there's going to be a counterplay. The moment they snowball in, there's going to be a fissure.
Oh,
things are going to go bad.
Uses the snowball.
He is very dead now.
And then,
one-way ticket to death.
No! Fate bolt to the back.
Almost got out of the... I do believe Vici Gaming will start putting a lot more pressure with the BKBs. They will look to fight the back Radiant Jungle.
He's blinked forward to farm here. Vici Gaming coming around the corner. Can they look it down? Oh, he's blinked forward again!
What?
You've got to be careful. They pop the drums. They're going to chase this one down. Fissure onto a Vorse. He's caught out. Echo Slam as well. There's no way he's getting out of that one. Tsuneko look for the re-relocate back out, but there was a time for it. And now 6 seconds before he returns, is he going to be able to get himself back to home? Ice 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 looking for gear. 3, 2, 1. Oh, he gets himself back just in the nick of
he's
time.
He's going to die too. Oh, oh, he has one charges.
Ooh.
So, okay, if Ice 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 doesn't miss that scream, that's 2 kills. So,
and now I mean, they do get themselves away.
This is what I was talking about earlier. The moment Na'Vi go for an aggressive play with their Lina, if there's any defensive support, this time it's the Rubick.
Gonna get caught out here by the Yule Supers there as well. Super pop the BKB. They do burst down FY hit first. Fisher coming out onto two. Tsuneko, he's gonna just get evaporated there. Super blows him up. They turn their attention towards Funnik now. He's gonna look for the TP. Will he be able to make it? No! Lose the beam from Howe. They'll clean up Funnik as well, and they take down two in return for losing them. Dendi coming in just with the Dragon Slave, trying to force VG back. And has caught out the SF of the Yule.
What?
At the same time, there's a bit of a fight going on. A Vorse jumping in on Tyson. Oh, and a void! Blows up Ice Ice Ice. Now he's going to go for the tower here. And the question is, are Vici going to be able to defend? Vici, they're still fighting in the mid lane. There's four of them. They blur Dendi. They're fighting one. They're moving forward here as well, seeing if they can find Artstyle. At the bottom lane, though, Na'Vi, they're continuing to push. A Vorse to Tsuneko standing their ground. He's looking for the Rex. He should be able to find it. And he will be able to find the melee Rex now. Ice 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 and Howard coming with the defense. Tsuneko, oh, with the turn of TP. He's out of there. He's back to base. He's A-OK. And Na'Vi, they take the bottom melee Rex, and they don't lose any Rex of their own in the mid lane.
I could not believe that was the outcome of that.
Okay, then for Tsuneko, I think he's trying to slow them down, and it's gonna work! It's gonna work, he's set them up! Super gets the mech off, looking for the Requiem, we'll find it. Telekinesis onto Dendi now, Funnik with the Morris Puncher, trying to continue the fight for Dendi, so the re-roll get back out, saving them from the Sonic Wave. Won't save Funnik though, they'll lose him there in the mid lane, but again, Tsuneko here with the plays. Into the top lane. How is that?
Who's finding who, really?
And SF and FY, but now FY with the telekinesis onto Dendi, trying to look him in place. Tsuneko coming in. Oh! Tries to look for the relocate out, not there in time, and now it's going to be Tsuneko. He's got 7 seconds left of his life.
He might actually survive.
He's got the Glimmer Cape in 7. Glimmer Cape in 7. Is he going to get out with the Glimmer Cape? Oh, no, he's not.
I did not see that cooldown. That is a problem.
Harder for them to defend their own high ground, because we can expect to see Fenrir jumping straight in. Talking about jumping straight in, Ice 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 going into Funnik. A Vorse turned out. They'll turn on to Ice 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 with a Mega Void! Blowing up the co-op! That's going to be Ice 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 down with the push from the rest of Vici coming out in the mid lane. Na'Vi, they are still down Dendi and Tsuneko, and the damage is going to be enough here. They'll find the range racks. They're looking for the melee racks as well. Can Na'Vi get them off this? It doesn't look like they can, and Na'Vi will lose this mid set of melee racks as well. So a full set of racks down here in the middle lane. Very nice for the side of Vici. Looking for Howe. Snowball forward onto Fenrir. Can they turn this fight? Na'Vi, Howe's going to pop the BKB, looking for his way out of this one. Now he's ready to just turn around and go back in. We'll blow apart style here. Now the question is, are they going to try and look for more fun? It gets the sigil out, trying to slow down the side of Vici. Ice Charge blocking up Howe. No, we'll be able to walk around them here. Duke it out. Havort, he's coming into the fight now with a snowball onto Howe. Looking for the lockdown. Havort's been tethered up by Ips. Tsuneko. Super getting caught up by the Yule's Light Strike, the Lunar Blade. Super's going to go down. Killing spree here for Havort as he takes down the SF. Fenrir now the trooper. Blink forward for Funny. Gets the Ice Charge. Blocks Fenrir up. And now Tsuneko turns up to the fire. Party with the experience, blowing Fenrir up. They'll get themselves another kill, Na'Vi. And Havort's now blind the pressure onto the mid lane. They might even be able to try and force out a buyback to the SF. Still 50 seconds as Super's off the map. Test. Vorse actually being the front liner here, straight onto the SF for the Mantra as well, looking for it, the BKB's being popped, the Echo's now, Vorse getting loaded with the Shadow Grave, gonna buy him time, he actually blinks himself out, Fenrir might go down, no he's still alive, Funnik's gonna be the first to lose his life here in this fight, now Tsuneko trying to retrieve Ice Ice Ice, jumping forward, he's gonna fight Tsuneko here as well, and two down on Na'Vi, this is gonna be the opening that Vici may look to take Roshan from.
Yeah, Na'Vi, Vorse, they're so scared of giving away the Roshan that they feel like they have to go in and check. And Kroos just can't take this fight, right? He doesn't have BKB, so the moment he engages, he has to get the hell out of there as Vici starts turning the heat on. And that little play in top where he lives.
Now we're going to see Vici. Vici, they're going to look to try and block him off here, moving straight up. TP. Oh, Arstyle actually cancelling the TP here, wanting to stick around to fight, but Arstyle's going to lose his life here. There's going to be the relocate out to save Havors. But poor
meanwhile, Howe is being chased a bit here. His TP got cancelled.
Vorse with the body blocks. Funnik as well. Look at these body blocks come out. How's it going to be in a lot of trouble? Vorse going forwards here. He's got a mana void. He's going to use it. They're looking to catch out anyone
Funnik
on the side of Na'Vi.
There is a gem on Ice Ice Ice. He needs to be really careful. He does have Blink too. Ice 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 is not seeing him.
They're going to go straight.
Oh, he's
going to be popped by Howe. Full commitment there to find the kill onto Funnik.
Doesn't look like they're going to go for it though. Luna will claim the tower with the Mantis.
Denji's walking down the lane with the relocate coming in as well. Sineka bringing in a force of the Abyssal Blade. Straight up to Super, we're up with... Oh! The Mana Void there! Another kill here for Vorst. A mega kill streak and a big kill to make it with as well. Finding the kill onto Super on that SF. He's being a bit sneaky.
Doing his coin challenge. Getting explore 90% sneaky. Of the map. Hopefully there's no coin challenge with that. That would be horrible.
Peachy, I want to go some in here. Okay, the Phantom Force can afford to get himself out of this one. Echo Sam, everything. Sonic Wave, can they kill it? Oh, they do. He's down. They finally kill him to a Force. He has got buyback available. Sonic can lift the TP out. Will be able to just find himself back to base.
Been hanging out a lot with Force this game.
Okay, they're going to go for Roche. And as you said, still with that duration of the double damage.
1350 crits.
And they're going to make such short work of it here. And I don't think there's any way that Na'Vi can stop it. Already down to half health. We're starting to see, well, Dazzle make a movement towards it, but Havorst still in the mid lane with Sineko. No chance to cast this one. Vici are going to find Roche. They get the Aegis, they get themselves the cheese here. And Ardstar, that's jumped up on the Fissure. In a lot of trouble as Vici converge onto him. We'll get the weave out. Shallowgrave isn't going to save him, though. And they're going to get the gem here as well. So wow. big pickoff there for Vici Gaming.
36 armor for the entire team for that last second. They're going to precast it.
This is such a hard defense for Na'Vi. Vici Gaming coming out of the mid lane. Hex onto Fnatic. The fortification will be coming out. Shallowgrave just in time here. Dendi is there. A Force is backed up as well here. He's ready for the defense with Sineko tethering him up. Buyback for Fnatic jumping in straight onto FY. The Shallowgrave stolen! FY still alive! And now he's going to contribute. Gets himself out. Steals the blink. FY's going to live. The snowball will go out to him. They just finally go down now. Dendi with the Laguna Blade onto Super. Bring him low. Ardstar. He's almost certainly going to die. Half finds the kill. They found two. Looking for Dendi. It's found. They've lost too many. Ardstar's under the base. The base is going down here. Now we're going to do something. And Vorst coming out. Looking for Hammer. Hammer. Oh, Echo's happening for Vorst. Hexed up. But Vorst. He's going to go down. He's got the buyback. Buyback here. He's looking for the defense.
They're just spamming out buybacks, trying to end the game right now. They fought out four heroes, knowing that Dendi has no buyback. There's no buyback on Sineko. There's no buyback on anyone anymore.
It's only a Forced and Funning left alive here on the side of Na'Vi. 20 seconds and Alistair's going to be back. I don't know.
Is Force considering this? He could buy Boots of Travel and look for this gambling. He just bought something. He just bought a moon shard.
Oh, he's going to be the moon shards.
He can't afford it.
Is this going to be it? Will the moon shards do it for him? Eats it up.
This is effectively a 5-on-3
for the crowd. We go BKB Bard looking for Super, straight in onto the SF, the Abyssal Blade drop. Can they kill him? Super getting low! He's down! They find Super! Now Sonic Wave onto Force gets hexed up though! They might lose him, but Force gonna keep him alive! Also, no, he shallow grabs himself! He shallow grabs himself! It's over! Vici Gaming take the game! Oh my goodness! Na'Vi are out, Vici Gaming! What an end to the game. They gave it their all, Na'Vi, but at the end of the day, too many mistakes. Vici Gaming, the superior fight, and as farmed as Havorst was, it wasn't enough to stand up against both the SF and the Luna of VG.
You're giving Mush the SF a very good start, so...
Dragon Knight.
And that's what they're doing, so it was a very nice call from you, but I'm a bit worried for the G.
Players in Southeast Asia. Now, I love the fact that they're dual laning right here because the fact they're still able to keep up and experience.
Oh, they might actually get your first blood here. They're able to snag it with an early ensnare and the dual lane.
Pretty much by himself, and you're seeing that right now. And it means that the solo experience he's getting is making such a big difference. Oh. But on top,
Io, he's done for. He's going to throw out a last ion shell. He knows he's dead. The moment that Fissure stops his TP, he's done for. So.
It does look like VP wants to get into this fight, and everyone's TPing down, but Lil might just get caught out.
Lil, totally done for the rest of Versus Pro, still gonna try and force this fight. KYXY is the first target, but of course, he's got that reincarnation. In fact, they even have the Song of Siren if they feel like this fight is not gonna go their way. So Fnatic, start backing up. Mushi pops the Song of Siren, and they're just gonna play it very, very safe here.
Whether or not you have that SNY, this Roche fight is gonna be so crucial. They don't have the sleep
The Ring King ulti. They've got two ultimates down to the side of Fnatic, but the element of surprise is there for Fnatic. They're going to be able to try and jump FG. He gets off the shell, great catch, Akimba. Bounce over that Fissure, back and forth. A big Echo Slam comes out, but it's still not enough. God, as well as Illidan, dropping lower and lower. Looks like they're going to be able to get God on the start. Now double Ion Shellin, but they just want to get out of here. Illidan is too strong. Mushi trying to sack himself over into Roche. No, he's actually got a health potion. Interrupted by the Fissure. Now Mushi very much dead. DK Phobos. No, rather FNG gets the kill. Lil, he's going to be able to go for the stun, but KYXway trying to finish him off. Needs a little bit more HP. Nice armlet targeting. Will be able to get out of that one. VP
vision it. It looks like they're just going to walk right in, but again, they don't have either of these abilities. And they're going to have to be fast about it because Lil is going to get the stun.
Here goes NA, just called out, is coming in. Spearbreaker bounces back, catching Imba, perfect timing. He's going to pop the ultimate though, and DK Bubbles gets eliminated by those two. KYXY on the front lines, trying to toggle as best as possible Surge, but not good enough. The SF goes down as well, and now Virtus Pro just looking for cleanup. Johnny's on his way out, the rest of the team trying to cover each other. Make sure that they don't lose anything else, but that's still
twice.
Starting off with the stun. Here comes the charge on the side. They're going to go for Johnny. The call down is there. They're going to catch out Mushi. He won't be able to get out the Sucker Siren. He dies immediately after it gets popped. Now Ohio throws out the wall. Good vacuum on it too, but there's just no more offense left. Echo Slam finishes off him. They managed to take away that Aegis, but catching Imba is going to be a little bit caught. KYXY trying to go for DK Phobos, but a beautiful Fissure block once again from Lil. Make sure that there's no escape for Fnatic. They drop four once again, and all they take is the Dazzle. Pickoff. It's going to be deep in VP territory. I feel like this fight, if it goes wrong for Fnatic, they may never have the opportunity to come back. They're going to leave the DK Phobos, blows them up immediately. Now the call down comes in, and Fnatic are going to be slowed down, but VP are not going to pursue. They accept the one tap, close as possible, with the call down coming in as well. They do have a good opportunity. Looks like Hechigimba's going to be the first one locked down by DK Phobos. Meanwhile, the rest of the fight, Illidan is able to take out the Lina immediately. Hechigimba also going down as well. They need a couple more right clicks. God just isn't there in time. Now Hechigimba going for the TP out. Lil sees him for half a second, but can't get the stun in time. So push out that middle lane, smoke up, and now heading for the Roshan pit, but it's already below half HP, especially with that medallion. It's going to be dropping fast. The Naga Siren Illusion is going to be leading the way. It spots out that Roshan is incredibly low, but Fnatic took a bit of a detour. They hit it up into the middle lane. Now they make the jump in Saga Siren, but it's too late. Already the Aegis is down. They're going to throw down the wall and try and take this fight anyway. Catching Imba goes for the ultimate. Echo Slam interrupts. Catching Imba. He's going to be blown up before he gets anything off, and now the fight looks disastrous as double BKBs are popped. They're ignoring KYXY. His reincarnation is blown, and the rest of Virtus Pro just looking forward. Fnatic. Ohio's going to be going down next to the creeps. KYXY with a blink TP away will be the only survivor there for Fnatic.
They're just out-coordinating Fnatic in these team fights. And, I mean, KYXY is going to go in, but can he actually do anything?
Yeah, he doesn't have the reincarnation, so he's got to play careful here. Shallow Grave being placed on Illidan. The ensnare's going to still catch him, and Fnatic desperately need to be able to make this fight work for them. Three-man vacuum, but you already have the Spearbreaker just charging deep in, making himself a target. Fire Breath comes through. Fnatic actually dropping a little bit low. Illidan in the background. There goes the Laguna Blade to take him out, but that's just the Aegis. KYXY trying to toggle as best as possible. Lil is going to be caught, but another great Shallow Grave keeps them alive. The back out call down. Still going to be able to catch Mushi here, and Illidan charging in without fear. Really wants to be able to clean up this support. Gets a little bit closer, but now he is being kited. No, oh, nice use there. The flat cannon manages to catch Mushi in the end for a godlike spree on Illidan, and the dive past the tier 3 tower works out to VP's favor. Still rocking just the SNY, and Wraith King only has, oh, jump in, catching Imba in a bit of trouble. He's going to be chain locked and taken out with the double damage. They will be able to get the turnaround kill on Lil, but it's still not worth it.
Johnny's actually
with Johnny. He's stuck in the trees, and God, well, trying to catch up. Looks like Johnny's going to be able to get some distance out, and G just kind of lets him go. He is a beast right now, and Fnatic, oh, they could be in a bad position here. They're going to go for the smoke up. Lil already sees him, missed the Fissure, but KYXY has been stunned up. They managed to get some stuns onto Lil, but KYXY is going to be sacked here. He loses a reincarnation, and the rest of Fnatic waiting to go back in. BKB is being popped now by VP, with Mushi popping that Song of Siren that leaves Illidan all by himself, but he doesn't care. He's going to man mode this one out. Catching Imba pops his BKB, trying to go for God, but he's just too damn tanky. DK Phobos bumping back, catching Imba with a charge. charge over to the supports as well. Two-man Fissure on top of that one. Kenshikimba is on the escape at the same time. Mushi may be sacrificed to the gyrocopter. Kenshikimba playing around with these centaurs, trying to clear through them. Echo Slam gets laid out. He goes down. And now the chase continues for Johnny with a charge on top. He's not going anywhere. It's only Ohio the offlaner who will survive once again. Fnatic just shy of getting team wiped.
VP is usually a team that's completely methodical. They'll wait, but they're deciding to just go for it right now. They can taste blood.
Oh, there's the two-man backing, but it's still not enough for them to be able to win the fight. The call-down gets laid out. KYXY, he's going to be going down again. Beyond Godlike already for Illidan, as he now marches to kill Ohio 12. Great Light Strike Array, though, catches multiple, and they'll take out DK Phobos to start with. And now Illidan going to be caught by the Wraith King stun, and more right-clicks. They can't quite get it. FNG's keeping Illidan alive. Johnny has one chance to be able to get a Dragon Slay, but he turns around to face up against God. Level 17 Dragonite will finally die here. As Ohio picks up the double kill, they hold their melee racks. Late game potential here. Solar Crest bringing Roshan. Look at it, it's already going down to 3k HP. And Fnatic are not going to be able to mount a response in time. Aegis already in the hands of Illidan. And TK Phobos, he wants to be able to force this fight. Charge right through Mushi, leading things up for Lil to be able to get a multiple stun. Johnny's going to be controlled up by TK Phobos. Meanwhile, farther up, they do manage to take out the Wraith King for their first life. Farther down, Mushi is trying to back himself away from the rest of VP. Nice two-man vacuum with wall on top. TK Phobos actually going to go down here. God, though, pops his BKB and now challenges Kenshikimba for superiority. Kenshikimba running away, but nice Saga Siren out from Mushi. They're gonna try and pop God here. They link all the Saga Siren. God gets brought a little bit low, but it's still not enough. The Shield Grave is there, and Kenshikimba desperate to be able to TP out, does not make it away. Johnny TP's out, but they lost their core. KYXY as well as Kenshikimba are down.
At best, this is gonna be a 3v4 fight for Fnatic.
Buyback is there. Ohio, two-man vacuum with the Shiva's on top, but the magic damage just isn't nearly enough. God, still very healthy as Illidan leads the charge here up against Kenshikimba, trying to desperately to get back to the fountain. Lina goes down, and Kenshikimba just barely gets back in time, but that is definitely a second lane of Rax. Illidan on the front lines here for this tier 3 tower, the last lane of Rax. This is do or die for Fnatic. Mushi is in an interesting position here. Gets caught out by Illidan. BKB activated. Mushi is already down and out. KYXY, he's going to go down as well. He does not have a buyback. The Blink Dagger picked up from Kenshikimba, but he may not have the opportunity to use it. Nice vacuum into the wall, but the ultimate just doesn't seem to do anything. Kenshikimba gets torn apart like paper. Ohio's next up, and there it is. GG, Fnatic call it. Their opportunities here at the International come to a close as Virtus Pro take them out in this best of one elimination match.
What a dominant performance by Virtus Pro. They don't even look phased. They're not even really, I'm sure they're happy, but it doesn't even look like that bothered them. They're like, we expected to go there, be clinical, take them apart, and that's exactly what they did. An absolutely dominant performance for them.
We saw an 8-0-0 game from him on his AM in the group stage. What else do you want from a burning AM?
All right, that's a surprising pick, the THD. It's most likely going to be support. If we said that Shaker was a support and Zeus was a core, it could be offlane as well.
So hard for you to fight against him, but might be a fight here is
early level one fight. Luo already pushing back against Jerix. They're going to try and battle over that bounding rune. MP actually dropping very low already. They need a couple more right clicks. Fate really gunning for it. Needs a little bit more. The lance comes out, but it's still not enough. He's going to survive with just a sliver of HP. Oh, he's got to throw the stun. Luo, Light Strike Array actually lands on him. He keeps the health potion alive. Now he's stuck. He's on the wrong side of the picture on that one. And the team MVP Hot Six start running him down.
Oh, he got
Light Strike Array landed. And that's going to be first blood going to Jerix.
That was almost so close to being a kill for IG, but they just managed to make that happen. The Earthshaker plus Zeus in the offlane would probably not do that well against the Spiritbreaker, because there's almost no kill possibility, and at bottom,
there's not even a question. Sunbee, he's got to be dead here. They pop the mango just to be able to have that extra land. Sunbee is trying to make the jukes here. Oh, what? So good, but it's just not enough. He's surrounded by three heroes. No matter what kind of jukes you move there, it's just never going to be enough. Just off the roof. He's able to pick up that ultimate. Still though, he's got to beware. Oh, nice pickup there. Jerix goes down to Ferrari, who now is going to be very rapidly closing
very
in on that
aggressive vision up,
and they now are surrounding Burning. Go see if there's any TPs here. The Silence is going to be able to land on Burning, already leading things up. They're just going to pop him real quick. Heen is kind of stuck here, but that's okay. None of IG are actually rotating. Not going to be able to get that tower. It will be denied. Meanwhile, the bottom lane, Brent actually going to be hit by the Spirit Breaker here. Intercepted, though, by Heen. The Silence is going to come out. Spirit Breaker thought he could take this one. Even with a 17%, there's no way he could beat out the Bloodseeker.
Is
in a bit of trouble here. Lil starts off with the charge. Already the Zeus ultimate going off. Just trying to keep the rest of IG back. There goes the ultimate. And the Spirit Breaker will be caught here. He's ruptured up and trying to run himself out of here. He's got the Shallow Grave TP away. No stuns coming out. The Lightning Bolt is there to stop at the last half second. And MVP Hot 6 do pick up the kill and save Heen at the same time. Pick up right now is finishing the BKB for Ferrari. Charges coming in. MVP Hot 6. Looks like they're going to be losing MP right away. Nice Fisher to intercept there from Jerix, but MP is still caught and immediately blown up. But it's still the Spirit Breaker on the wrong side of the Fisher and will be chased down by Ferev. The rest of IG leave it up for a 1-for-1 exchange.
Oh, Kendall's hyped still.
Burning starts going for Sunbeat here. He doesn't actually have anything, no TP whatsoever. He's going to be run down for the next Lance, and Burning does pick up a kill. The health.
Ferrari, he has an invis rune. Do they have any sentries for this? I don't actually think they have any idea that this is coming. As Luo's coming in from the top, Burning's TPing in, and Ferrari with the chase.
Nice intercept. Luo's immediately going to be stopped there by the ice path. He still gets off the ultimate, but he has Rupture on him, and Frem wants to be able to pick up this kill, but it's going to be slowed down by Shellgrave. MP, meanwhile, turns as much damage as possible onto Ferrari, but he's still going to be blown up immediately by the raises. Spiritbreaker gets out, and MVP Hot 6 lose their Lina. Sunbeat comes in, but the rest of IG are still very healthy. Again, this Bloodseeker just isn't going to get a whole lot of stacks on his passive right now.
Yeah, part of the problem right there was that Ferev actually had the Rupture stolen by him, and Chuan actually just used it on MP, and so it was pretty much impossible for them to fight. And at the same time, they did manage to grab Luo, as Jerix is going to get Phantom Lance over here.
Some of their supporting cast, such as the Jakiro with that liquid fire. IG, though, realize what's going on. The charge goes right through the Roshan pit, and now it's put Heen up on the cliff. Meanwhile, Sunbeam, he's going to be stopped. He actually tried to go for the TP out, but Luo says, no way, you're going to be the first one dead in this fight. MVP Hot 6 trying to turn this one around. Actually start backing themselves up. Rev turning around. Heen stuck on the cliff, still in trouble, but MVP Hot 6 have no way to be able to help him out. Heen just waiting for his opportunity to TP away. Goes for it now, but the TP, oh, it completes just in time ahead of the ice path. Rev dropping lower. MP still has the Laguna Blade, and IG think about diving that tier 1 tower, but realize it's a bit too dangerous. And once again, look at MVP Hot 6 are not really going to find the opening for Roshan. Really desiring. Now, Sunbeat, oh, he's gonna be caught. Nice ice path from Chuan to start things out. And Sunbeat, well, he pops his ultimate, realizing he's gonna be blown up right away. In fact, our Spirit Breaker targets a large amount of damage from the Laguna Blade. Nice race from Ferrari to finish off the Zeus, and now they keep moving forward. Ian slowed down by that Lance, but IG. Oh, charge in. Fisher already stopping. Oh, he's taking a ton of damage, but already the Shallow Grave is out. And now here comes that damage reduction out from Ferrari. Ferev is just not finding the openings he really needs. Once again, the Dazzle is always there with the heals and the Shallow Grave. Is closing in on the Blink Dagger, but could be stopped here. Nice turnaround, Fisher, but immediately countered as Chuan catches that one, grabs him with the Telekinesis, and Spirit Breaker finishes him off with the Phantom Lancer on the side. Waiting things out. Zeus ultimate being popped. And they definitely know that IG are smoked up. Nice strike array actually landing on Ferrari. Maybe they can blow him up right away. The Ferrari, though, is countered. He's going to be able to get off the BKB. Almost popping the ultimate. Now revs it up. Sunbeat completely trapped there. Nothing he can do about that one. Ferrari has to wait out.
They don't see this charge coming, but I don't even know if he continues to go for this.
He keeps on going. And oh, Jesus, already blowing up the Jakiro. Rest of MVP Hot 6, not much they can do.
Advantage that the Shadow Fiend has over.
Uh-oh, Ferev, he's going to be caught here by the Telekinesis. They will immediately chain stun him down.
With the mech boost and one Shadow Wave, it pretty much cuts the Lina in half.
Chuan, he's going to find it. Heen trying to go for the TP out, but immediately blink in from Chuan plus the Telekinesis stop. And it's just inevitable at this point. Heen has got to be accepting his fate soon. His Spirit Breaker comes in. The Lance is there as well. He just backs himself up into a corner, but there is no escape. Charge coming in. Heen is the target. Turns around for the ice path. Once again, does get it off. And there's the Blood right on top of that one. They changed on him pretty well. Ferev now starts going for that kill with the ultimate on top of that one. Spiritbreaker takes a lot of damage.
Oh,
but
that's
now he's
going
down
so
by that
Scotty
so much. And now he's going to be bumped by the Spiritbreaker ultimate as well. He goes down. What could have been a pickoff just proves to be too tough for MVP Hot 6 to get. And now Burning. Once more, he's going to start charging uphill, immediately to defuse the blade on the Sunbeam. He just gets ripped apart. MP, he's next online. Yule Scepter is only going to set up Ferrari for a perfect ultimate. It's Heen as well. Ultra kill godlike for Ferrari. As looks like IG are finally ready to take this to MVP Hot 6's base. IG. So Forev, he farms up the bottom lane. Meanwhile, the rest of his team pushes into the jungle. Smoke on smoke. MP gonna be leading the way. The Fisher already stunning up, burning. Their chain stun him decently, but all that new damage only brings him to about half. Now Zombie's gonna be targeted. Ferrari just jumps forward, and there it is. Before the fight's even done, GG is called from MVP Hot 6. They knew this one was over for a while.
And this is so bittersweet as MVP Hot 6. They tried so far, just weren't quite there, but IG take a victory, and they did it in such a dominant fashion, showing that they are a team that should be feared.